Oh, welcome back, guys. Today, I did say I was wanting to get some automated crafting going, and I was going to use logistics pipes for that. But I am not doing too well on resources at the moment. Got one diamond in total. Got quite a number of other ores around, but it's not fantastic, so I'm going to craft myself an item, and I'm off mining. I'll go mining off camera, but let me show you this item first. So we'll have a look at some covalence dust. Now this isn't an item I've used in any of my previous series, but it's going to be quite handy, because I'm trying not to use equivalent exchange too much, but this is an equivalent exchange item. What I mean by that is I don't want to be transmuting between items all the time. Okay, so this is the bottom level covalence dust. It can be used to repair, well, stone tools, that kind of thing. But if you put it around a stick, you can hit walls with it, and it'll tell you an average value of ore. Now, one is for stone, 8,100 and something or other is for diamonds. Now, I'm going to upgrade this, because that doesn't have a very long range. You can upgrade it with the second tier of covalence dust to this divining rod. Welcome back, guys. Back down at the lava level. So this is Y15. I want to be down a bit lower. This is where I was mining out before. That's Y12. We'll try Y11. Okay, now with this divining rod, we can change the mode with a G key. So divining rod is set to mid-range now. If we set it again, it's short range, 3x3. But 16x3 should be great. It's best found 2048. That's a value that's a quarter of a diamond. So that'll be gold. Let's see if we can find that. Or it might be in lapis. Not sure what value lapis is at. Let's just continue down here, see if we can find any gold. So it won't have gone further than 16 blocks. Let's try hitting it up again. Oh, there's something still there. Ah, there it is. So that's what I'm going to use to try to get my mining gun in the right direction to find some diamonds. So I shall see you back at my base. Well, that was a rather successful trip, and I do wish I had some larger bags now, and I'll have to sort that out soon. I've got quite a lot of tungsten ore, so 10 of those, 23 diamonds, lots of other nice resources, silver, tin. So that's a pretty good mining trip. I'm pretty pleased with that. It should give me enough resources to get on with building a sorting machine to sort all this stuff out. So I shall see you in a few once I've emptied out my bags. Hey everybody, welcome back. I was gonna build something new, which I haven't made in any of my series before, and it's a drill. Now this can be charged up in a bat box or MFE or whatever you've got around, and I'm going to upgrade this to diamond. Now this will never wear out, but it will run out of power. So I'm just going to charge it up in my battery box. Welcome back, guys. So, I've been using the diamond drill for a little while. Now, one thing you'll notice with it is it really doesn't last very long on the power that you can give it. And that's what these battery packs are for. The lap packs are upgrades for the backpack. And at the moment, I'm just going to make myself a backpack and see how I get on with that. So that's a 10. 6 batteries and electric circuit. Okay, this holds up to 60,000 DU, which is more than we're storing in here. I wanted to drain these machines anyway, because I'm going to move upstairs with this stuff so that creeper damage doesn't get in the way. Oh, welcome back, everybody. Just piping this lava upstairs, and in the meantime, I am going to create myself an MFV. An MFE, which is a little bit of more storage. Yeah, this might have changed recipe. Let's see. So we're going to want some of these. Four of those. Quite expensive, but the amount of storage you get with it is makes it worthwhile. Now these don't stack, so you have to make sure you've got enough inventory space. See, what else do we need? Machine block. Gonna have to cook up a bit of iron. What else do we need? We need a bit of gold insulated cable. And it needs to be double insulated. Now, the first insulation level you put on it is single insulation. And if you just put it in there again, you'll get the 2x insulation. Looks like it's done. Well, I started to run wires around, and it was quite a lot of wires needed, and I thought maybe there's another way to do this, and there is. It's going to be a slow way, but I can discharge this the bat pack into this device, so I can transfer the power from downstairs to upstairs and store in here. Hi guys, welcome back. So I'm going to have to move these machines, and one way to do it is to use a wrench. Now, recipe for this wrench is using bronze ingots. Now, it's different to the forestry bronze we made the other day. In fact, the wrench here is for forestry, so it's not. It isn't the same thing at all. And to make the bronze for industrial craft, it's this recipe. I'm just going to smelt these down. Now, if I was to use the normal wrench, there's a chance that I'd break these machines when I remove them. What I'm going to do is upgrade it to an electric wrench, power up the electric wrench, and then I'll set it to a lossless mode, which means I won't be able to break these machines on moving them. There's the wrench, and the recipe for the electric wrench. There we go. I'm just going to power this up in here. I'm supposed to be able to hold the M key right click, or right click and M key, but neither seem to do anything for me, so I'm just going to have to hope I get lucky. Okay, so we've got two electric generators back so far. Okay, alright, we've got everything back safely. Oh, welcome back, guys. I finally transferred most of the energy across, which means it's time to start implementing the plans upstairs. I need to create an LV transformer. This is to convert the power from the high power from the MFE, or sorry, to convert from medium power from the MFE down to low power, which is what feeds into those machines currently. I don't have them upgraded. I would like to, but not immediately. So I'm just going to plug that recipe in. It's quite a cheap recipe. What have I done with my wood? Okay, let's go and have a look upstairs. It's just temporary to give me access to the bottom of all this stuff. Ah, okay, so there is my MFE. I need to be one more out from here. Or maybe I'll go out two. Just give myself plenty of room. Okay, so between this device and the machines, now I've put gold cable down here because I'll be able to connect them up eventually once I've upgraded them directly into the MFE. But for the time being, I'm going to that didn't go quite to plan. Oh, what did I put up? I put the bat box, not the... Oh no. Don't think that should have been so disastrous. Just going to place that down there. And the high power side... Oops. So high powered side is a side with three dots on it. So if I face it, right click it with the wrench, so that should be fine now. And if I connect those together with a high power cable, so it's going to be the gold cable between these two. Okay, no explosion. So that could run the machines, but what I'm going to do is remove that, place the bat box down there, and shift click it so it goes and faces either direction. Now let's see. So that's drawing power now. That means we've got sort of two storage devices. One's obviously a lot higher power, but this one is the one that's going to be running the machines. So that's all sorted. Now I need to go upstairs and fit up the generator. So I'll be back with you in a moment. I'm just going to take down this mud as well while I'm here. Okay, we're upstairs now. Now into the MFE. I can. So every side of these. Oh, that's not facing the right way. Let's get it facing the right way. So the one dot side of MFE and the bat box. Let's make sure that's right. Yep. One dot side is the output face. Every other side of those is an input. So I'm just going to run some copper cable around the back of the MFE because that's an input into it, and that. The copper cable's fine for the geothermal generator. I'm going to face it facing that way. Now, this thing, if it's... I will go over that another time because I'm going to have to run some red power cable around. Okay, anyway, that should be good enough to go. So let's make sure all that's working. Now I could put gold pipe down here, but I'm not too fussed about it. Start to tidy up around here as well now. Okay, so we just want to see this generator running now. Okay, that's running. Are we getting power through to this? Yes, it's going up, so that's fine. I'm going to switch off all this stuff at the moment. And I don't need to be down there again for the moment, so I'm just going to cover it over. Okay, so this is where the machines are going to go. So even though it's gold cable up here, it's still running on low power because the bat box and the MFV are in the way at the moment, so these should all be fine. Now I need to start on the logistics stuff. Let's make sure these are all getting power, so they've all, you see the red line there, so they're getting power. Everything's working quite nicely. Still got a good view. And I've got access to the MFE down there, so I can charge up items in there quite easily. Okay, that's pretty cool. I'll be back with you in a moment. I need to sort out some items. Okay guys, well, I'm back up in this room. Pretty happy with the way it's turned out. We're going to do a little bit of logistics work with logistics pipes. It's pretty cool. It's extremely expensive in terms of materials, but it does negate the need for any kind of machines to pull out of, you know, like the redstone engines and wooden transport pipes to pull items from machines, because gears are included in the pipes themselves. This also may not be the best layout. I like to have items separated into separate chests. I find it helps me find the item I'm looking for. Although the logistics system, you know, you can request items out of chests, and you know, some of the later parts of the logistics pipes that I won't be implementing just yet, it might benefit from just having a few of these chests lined up and having everything going into those without worrying about it too much. But for the time being, I'm going to stick with this. And as I said, this stuff is it's quite expensive, so we need diamond transport pipes to kick off everything. Now, the diamond transport pipes are normally used just for separating items. You can route items going different directions. That's part of standard build craft without logistics pipes. But we're going to upgrade that into the basic logistics pipes. Now you do get a good few of these. Okay, for the time being, I'm just going to use standard logistics pipes pretty much all along here. Now what these have, and if I get a wrench, now a new type of wrench, okay, stone gear and iron, okay, I should have some of those. Now I've already placed these in here because I was just smelting them up to make sure I had enough. Okay, so this is the buildcraft wrench. Now if we click on the logistics pipes, you see you can set in here the requested items. So this is going to be just for sorting items into chests it won't pull items out of them, and we're going to have to do some work in the future to do that, but this is the basic sorting system combined with smelting. Now, I'm only going to do the smelting stuff in today's episode, and I'll probably just do the rest of these off camera, because all it's going to be doing is putting down each of these basic pipes all the way along there. Now for these, I'm going to be upgrading the basic pipes, and the reason for that is I want to have two functions. I want to be able to put items into these and extract them back out, which means we need a chassis pipe, which I can't spell. You've got Mach 1, Mach 2, Mach 3, Mach 4, Mach 5. These marks are all about how many functions you can give each of the pipes. I only need logistics chassis pipes 2. This gives me 2 functions on each pipe. That's just iron surrounding a basic pipe. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So that's going to be my input chest for the whole system. So I need 6 of these. So earlier on you might have seen that this line here was red. It meant that the system wasn't connected to anything. Now it's turned green because it is. This here is just standard cobblestone pipe. I don't need anything more than that. And same with this one here. And that's just so that I can fit another machine in here in the future, as and when I need to, but yeah. Okay, so if we right click on these now, you can see there's 2 slots in here, and this is where it gets even more expensive. These are for modules. Now let's have a look at the module. Okay, so it's a blank module. It's used in all of these recipes. Item sync module is similar to the basic logistic pipe. You can set it to request an item to come in, or a selection of items to come into that particular module. Extractor modules, that'll extract an item from something every 5 seconds, I think it is. It could be 3 seconds or 5 seconds. Extractor 2, or the Mach 2, is to extract every second. Quick sort module pulls items from an object and routes them through the system, and this is going to be attached to my initial chest that everything comes into, so we do need one of these. The diamond gear. So let's have a look at the blank modules. That's the recipe for the blank modules. Item sinks. And the extractor modules too. And now, okay, I'm just about done here. You see me making up the items. You see me being an honest man. Okay, this is the quick sort. Okay, so that's done. That's the extractor modules. Need to upgrade 4 of these to module 2. Right, so we can start installing the modules anyway. So in here I want 1 item sync. I'm going to click on this icon. Say it's default route. It means everything will come to here if it's got nowhere better to go. We're going to do the quick sort. That doesn't have any click items, it just will sort anything that comes in there. Okay, in here I'm going to have sync module and an extractor module 2. Now if we click on that, we can set what sides we want items to be pulled from, and these machines all pull from the side. So this is where using logistics pipe is so much more convenient than normal piping. It is, you know, it's not taking me that long to set this system up compared to the other machines and, you know, everything that had to go into the industrial craft or bullcraft or red power ones, sorting things I've set up in the previous series. So this is really simple, it's really powerful, and it's also really expensive. But, you know, the expense, in the end, I think it's going to be worth it. Okay, remember what I said about these sync modules? These are for requesting aims. Very similar interface to, or exactly the same interface to this. Okay, let's continue. Item sync. I'm just going to stick it down there. Extractor. Set the extractor to the side. Oh, where are they? What is it doing? Okay, so I did have some iron in there. Now it's got an extractor attached to it. It can extract the items out of there. Did I set that to the side? I did. Okay, good. This one, extractor module 2 to the side. And there was some other stuff in there. An item sync module in there as well. And then the last one, just a standard extractor. I don't really care how quickly the resin comes to me. And we'll set that to the side as well. Okay, last thing to do is plug the items into the system to tell it where things need to go. So I'm going to have to empty my inventory a little bit. So this will be the last time you'll see these stuff. And I'll be back with what I need to get the items to sort. Okay guys, I'm back with the items I need. So this item sync module here needs the ores. So different to the red power, it won't use these items up, so you don't waste anything by setting this up. And we'll do the same for this one. In here we need to put items that smelt. That's gold dust and cinnabar, or dusts and cinnabar for the time being. Okay, let's plunk some items in and see what happens. So in here the cinnabar's come straight through, we can't macerate it. Into the macerator we've got some items. And because we haven't told cinnabar where to put those, it's just put them back in there. If we come over to this pipe, we should be able to just put that in there. And there the things come across. Brilliant! So if we have a look in there now, so we've got four in there. We should see those cinnabars. So there's no cinnabars gone back to the default route. And once these smelt comes out, it goes along. And that is so much cleaner than having redstone engines or red power engines all over the place. Just very neat solution. Right, what's going on with these things? So the dust is going back to there. Now, why is the dust going straight back? That's set as request. Because cinnabar's in there. This one here should. Okay, got ya. So those ores were going back because they had nowhere better to go. And now they have somewhere to go. Now it does try and send the items down. If it can't find somewhere for them, it'll send them back to the default route and then sort them again when it can, when it detects that the system is free to use them. Now, in this one here, I'm going to set up gems. this one here is the gold. Here is iron, copper, and then I need to get some silver and tin. Now if I just throw these in here, they should all sort out properly. Beautiful. Okay, there we have silver. So I'm just going to take one of those. Okay, there goes the silver. I'm not sure why that looks like a different colour. These are... So most of these are iron chests, some are the wooden chests. The iron chests give you a double wooden chests amount of space, and some of them are the copper ones, so a little bit cheaper than the iron chest to make, but it depends on the rarity of the material how much I think I'm going to need as to what I've set up there. Okay, well that's it guys, that's the basics of my logistics sorting system for the moment. Very simple but expensive. Now eventually we're going to have to do something to the on top of what we have over here to allow us to do automatic crafting, pulling items out of the chests. But for the time being, this is going to work quite well. Off camera, I'm going to complete the network by adding some more of these pipes down here to route all the items I'm going to be interested in. Okay, well thank you for watching guys, hope it's been informative. Hope I know other people have made similar systems, hopefully this is a guide on how to set up the cheap version of the system to get you going when you've just started in a level and you want to start sorting items. I'm doing this without having a quarry or other means of gathering materials at the moment. This is just from a couple of mining trips. You can pretty much get yourself set up with something like this, and I think it's pretty cool. I think the whole system is pretty awesome. This logistics pipe it takes so much less time to build than any of the other sorting systems I've built in my previous series, so I'm pretty pleased with it indeed. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.